a lot of us have had it where you get a candidate contacting and say, I need a proposer, I need a seconder, and assume you're going to do it. And being a proposer and a seconder for an APC candidate is a serious undertaking. And in this video, I'm just going to give candidates a few tips on how to get a proposer and seconder. Look, your proposer and seconder, you need three. Somebody to propose and two seconders. That makes three, of course. They've got to be MRICS or FRICS, but no more than two has to come from your own firm, which means you've got to get out there and network a little bit. Now, don't just choose somebody randomly. So if you're watching this and we've never met and you want me to second your application, tough, because I don't know you. And I'm not being nasty saying this, but the reason for this is what RICS say on where the proposer or seconder approves you. This is what they say. So if you ask me to second or propose your application, this is what I'd read online from RICS. You have been nominated to support the following application for election as Chartered Surveyor, MRICS, or as an Associate Member, ASOC, RICS. Please take one of the actions, yes. So if I want to propose a second year, this is what I've got to agree to as a Chartered Surveyor. Select yes to approve your support for the candidate. You propose and recommend the candidate from personal knowledge or from careful inquiry, as in every respect worthy of election, and propose them to the Governing Council as a proper person to be admitted to the RICS. Which is quite a serious undertaking for the person proposing a seconding. A proper person. You've got to say you're a proper person. And if I don't know you, I can't say that. So please don't randomly pick people you've seen online or you've heard of and say, oh, will you be proposing counsellor? This is why you need to get out there, whether it's in person or virtually, and build a network. It's dead easy to build a network these days. You've got all the fantastic matrix groups. And, you know, if you're an APC candidate and not having some interaction with matrix, shame on you, shame on you. Or RICS, you know, they've got the online, whatever they call it, my RICS, the online forums, which are great, and you know, you can throw things around. LinkedIn, you know, LinkedIn's really good to start forming a professional network, preferably local. And if you do get the chance to get out there and mingle with other APC candidates or Chartered Surveyors, do it. RICS put on lots of events. Matrix put on lots of events. Yes, you might have to travel a little bit to get to them. But, you know, you need to do it as an APC candidate. Because when you need a proposer or a seconder, yes, you can get two from your firm. But the third one, so you're going to have to know more Chartered Surveyors. Now, it might be that you work alongside other firms, you know people from other firms, you deal with people from other firms who are Chartered Surveyors, so that's easy. But, you know, you might work for a non-RICS regulated firm. You might be the only RICS member in that organisation. So you might be using external counsellor. Who knows? There's loads of ways you can do your APC. So don't assume somebody's going to do it. Also, if you're asking somebody to be a proposer or a seconder, yes, make sure you know them and they know you. It is a serious undertaking. But also make sure you give them time. And the time scale is very important. You must submit your final assessment within 3 months of your proposer and your seconders approving your application. So it is a small window of time. So don't leave it to the last minute when your proposer is on holiday or is too busy or doesn't want to do it anymore and you have to find somebody else. So you must submit within 3 months. You've got a 3-month window of opportunity to get your proposer and seconder. Also tell them, if they approve, keep in contact, give them the nod, right, have you got the email yet from RICS? Oh, I haven't checked. Or it might have got caught in the spam folder. So kind of walk them through it if they're external. If they sat on the desk next to you, it's quite easy. But if they're in another organisation, it is quite difficult. The chartered surveyors that support you must either be MRICS or FRICS. You don't have to have a fellow like in the old days. In the old days, you have to have one, at least must be a fellow. You don't. Everybody can be MRICS or FRICS. And they don't need to be in the same pathway. They don't need to understand technically what you do. It's about you're a decent person. You're not some kind of head the ball or you've got to bring, you know, bring the profession into disrepute. So it is, yeah. It's like, to me, it's like the person who signs or approves online your passport application. Is this, as RICS say, you are a proper person to be admitted to RICS. You're a good egg and you're not going to bring the RICS into disrepute. Proposer can decline, so that's why don't select somebody randomly. If the person declines, their name will be removed from the application. People do sometimes put randomers on. Some cheeky so-and-so put me down as the counsellor, and I hadn't a clue who they were. I really didn't have a clue who they were. So I'm going to the RICS and said, please take this person off right now. God loves a tryer, but to get the proposer and seconder, you will need their RICS membership number. And even though I have been an RICS member since 1992, I think, I don't know my membership number off the top of my head, but you can find out any RICS members membership number, whatever they call the membership number these days, from the Is Your Surveyor Qualified directory of membership on the RICS website. Actually, going through this process, there is a video on YouTube of a walkthrough of this happening. So, which is, you know, before you start pressing the buttons, you can watch. And RICS publishes it. It's quite a good video, to be honest. Just walking through. So before you start clicking away on the assessment system online, you can actually see somebody do it as a dummy run. A dummy run. So it's an odd one, is this, because there's not that much in the candidate guides. There's no, you know, they refer to proposer and seconder once, but they don't actually say what it is. And you don't actually see what it is when you start applying, so you don't want to be doing this the week before and they're on holiday, the person you've agreed it to do. So as I said, the main thing is you must submit for final assessment within 3 months of the proposer and seconder doing the business online. It's all done online, so just be aware that some proposers and seconders may not be familiar with the RICS website. Offer to sit with them even through another organisation. If you think, oh, I've never done it before, well, I'm more than happy to come with you. They're doing you a big favour by doing this, so make it as easy as you can for them. So yeah, a little quirk of the RICS APC. I very much agree with having to have proposers and seconders. One, because it makes you get out there and talk to other chartered surveyors. And two, yes, you know, if you are a non-fraudster and your reputation is absolutely shocking, it is one way of filtering out any I'm going to phrase this carefully, any people not a proper person, to use RICS's language. Thanks for watching. Good luck, as I always say, good luck with your APC. You know, this YouTube channel is here to help you pass. And if you're in the right job and you follow the guidance from RICS, you'll get there and you will be a chartered surveyor. Thanks for watching. See you soon.